I'm smiling because we have a fine young man sitting next to me. He's a high school student in New York, and he just won a $250,000 prize for a science project that could be used to help farmers prevent crop damage. It's Benjy Firester. That's the man who's sitting next to me. He's 18-year-old, and he's with me now. Benjy, congratulations.
Thank you.
What's this got to do with the Irish potato famine?
So the disease I studied is called potato lay blight, and it's the disease that killed all the crops in Ireland in the 1840s, which was part of the cause of the Irish potato famine. Mm. Now, although we don't see it in the news every day, this disease is still prevalent all over the world, and it causes billions of dollars of damage and epidemics. So what I did is I invented a mathematical model which predicts the spread of the disease, and this gives farmers the necessary information to protect their fields and prevent epidemics.
That was pretty good. I mean, wow. I didn't think you could explain it so that I would understand it, but I did. I mean, that's really very good. So you look at weather patterns, I take it, and where this disease, this infection is located, mm-hmm. and the wind patterns, and then you predict where this thing is going.
Exactly. Yeah.
That's it.
Mm-hmm.
Do people... Now, you invented the algorithm.
Yes.
Which is an equation which takes in all these weather patterns and brings it all together.
Mm-hmm. So the part I invented was figuring out exactly how these things interact. So what times do we need to look at the wind directions, which fields we need to look at, and how does all that correspond to, like, in a probability, or what's your risk of infection? Mm. And then the algorithm just puts all this data together from all the infected fields and all the times the wind direction, all the times the wind can be moving the disease, and figures out what's going to happen in the subsequent week.
That's an enormous amount of information to all pull together and pull it within your equation. Is that another word for an algorithm?
Yes.
So you've got to pull it all together from everywhere.
Mm-hmm. Well, part of the model is figuring out what data is important and what's not important. Mm. So if you look at the wind throughout an entire day, it's going to be very hard for the computer to figure out what's happening. But the disease can only spread within a very specific amount of time. So the first thing the model does is it looks for these times where the disease can actually spread to limit the data to something it can actually calculate with high accuracy.
You know, if I were looking around for a science project and trying to win $250,000, I don't think I would have come up with something to do with the Irish potato famine. How did you come up with this?
Well, I was looking to do research in mathematics and computer science. Those are the fields I'm really interested in. And so when I arrived at this lab that I was working at in Israel, actually, where my family's from, they were looking at many different ways to model diseases and track it. It's a field called plant pathology or epidemiology. And this disease has been studied for decades at this point now. The data set I've been working with is over 15 years old at this point. So it was a problem that's been around for a while and continues to be so. And I wanted to explore new ways to look at this disease and how it spreads using the tools of math and computer science.
$250,000, that's a lot of money.
As one college tuition.
Is that what it's going for?
Yeah.
I hate to break bad news to you, but I believe that money is taxable. Did you know that?
I'm still glad to have won it.
Good answer.
Which college do you want to go to?
I've been accepted to Harvard.
You have been accepted to Harvard. Now he tells us at the very end of the whole thing. And you're studying math?
Probably math and computer science, yes.
Do you object, not you, but people who do algorithms and things, and they're good at math, they're called geeks. Do you object?
No, it's okay. I've accepted the term.
Is there a term you would prefer?
No, I don't.
Rich geek. When do you go to Harvard?
This coming year. I'm a senior now, so I'm graduating, and I'll go to college.
Who presented the prize?
The prize is presented by the Regeneron Science Talent Search. So Regeneron's the sponsor, and the Science Talent Search is run by Society for Science and the Public.
Okay. It's great having you on the show, Benjy.
Thank you.
I know you wanted to be called Benjy. I found it hard to do that, but nonetheless, congratulations, young man.
Thank you very much.
Very, very well indeed. Well done, sir. Thank you. All right.